A library provides one or multiple functionalities that can be very useful. We're going to try out a library. I put a link in the description. This is Stick by RxI, a library that allows you to put a delay on functions. First, download the file. Click on tick.lua, click on raw, select everything and copy it. Now go to your text editor, create a new file and paste the code. Save the file in the same folder as your main.lua. And name it tick.lua. Now go back to the first web page. Here we see how to use the library. First, we need to require the file, store the returned object in a variable, and call the update function of the object. So let's do that. Tick equals require tick. Oh, by the way, functions with one argument don't require parentheses. Now, I do recommend you still use them with other functions, but for require, it's common usage to leave them out. And now in the updater, we do tick.update delta time. Let's use this example code to test the library. We call tick.delay, passing the function we want to call and the delay as arguments. When you run the game, you'll see it takes 2 seconds before it prints hello world. Looks like the library works.
But isn't using libraries bad? Shouldn't I learn how to do this myself?
If you're interested in how it works, then yes, you should learn how to make it yourself. But otherwise, it's perfectly okay to use a library. In my games, I use about 10 libraries. They provide functionalities that I don't really understand how to make myself, and I'm simply not interested in learning it. Lua also has built-in libraries, better known as standard libraries. For example, print and require are part of the standard library, but also the table.insert and table.remove functions. An important library we haven't looked at yet is the med library. It provides some important functions which we will definitely use in future videos. For example, med.random gives us a random number. Let's try it out. Inside the function where we create a rectangle, replace the 100 of speed with med.random 100, 500. Run the game. You'll see that every time we create a rectangle, it will have a random speed. In the future, we'll create our own library so you get a better understanding of how they work. Now that we understand what libraries are, we can start using a class library. Thanks for watching.